Hello friends, this is Dr. Ravi Ram, your EIS coach. In the previous sessions, we have covered chapter 1 of EIS, and in chapter 2 also, the financial and accounting modules also, we have touched briefly about ERP systems, how to audit the ERP systems, enterprise resource planning systems. In this session, we will continue with the same, which is nothing but business process modules of ERP systems, which are nothing but varieties of applications, varieties of business processes, and for large organizations, how these individual processes interact with each other. We will try to understand that. We have discussed about integrated and not integrated systems. So ERP, Enterprise Resource Planning System, are integrated systems where individual departments or functions, they have to coordinate and integrate with each other. Like, I think I have mentioned an example called symphony orchestra. All instruments of a symphony should work together to produce a great concert. Similarly, for any business, all these individual functions should work together. How are we doing that in the recent business? Mostly automated. So business processes need to be automated. They need to work in tandem with each other. They need to coordinate with each other. And then the business objectives should be met, meaning running the business. So for that, we are going to focus on business process modules to start with today or in this session. So business categories, three varieties of, you know, we can classify businesses at higher scale or a larger scale, like trading businesses, manufacturing businesses, service businesses. Trading businesses typically are nothing but buying and selling goods without any modifications as it is. That is, inventory accounting is a major aspect in this trading business, because we don't manufacture things. So purchase and sales transactions cover major portions of accounting in this. So this industry requires accounting from inventory also. Mostly trading businesses have this. What about manufacturing businesses? This type of business model include all aspects of trading business plus aspect of manufacturing. Manufacturing is nothing but buying raw material, changing its form, meaning using a process, and selling it as a part of trading. So inventory accounting is important, as well as other accounting like manufacturing modules are also important here. What about service businesses? This type of business, you would have heard insurance business, banking business, telecommunication business. These are not manufacturing businesses. These are all services businesses. What do they do? So basically, knowledge, architects, chartered accountants, we are all into service business. So we don't have any inventory, but what do we have? Like courier services or security services, we may not require any inventory, but we require other accounting aspects. So by and large, these are the business categories of any business process modules. Can you think about any business other than these three? Varieties of business, it's a challenge. Any businesses other than trading businesses, manufacturing businesses, service businesses, any other types of business, can you think? I doubt it. Why? Because any business, any organization, any business, any company would fall under these three categories only. So for automation of their business processes, we have to focus on related to these three broader categories. And within those categories, there are functional modules. What is a function? An activity. Function has various meanings. In mathematics, functions are different. In real life, functions are nothing but gatherings and, you know, celebrations. In case of businesses, functions means department, a specific activity. So those are, they may change based on the type of the business. So different business units may be there. So like this, these are varieties of business functions. financial accounting, controlling modules, sales and distribution, human resource, production planning when it is a manufacturing company, materials management when it is a manufacturing company, quality management, it applies to both services and manufacturing, plant maintenance, mostly for manufacturing, project systems, both for service service and also manufacturing, as well as trading systems, supply chain, trading systems plus manufacturing, CRM in any of the business, customer relationship management. So in a broader sense, any of those three broad categories, trading, manufacturing and services, we can divide various functions like this. Okay, and there may be some sub functions also, but however most of the business functions may fall under this category. So what is the enterprise relationship, enterprise resource management or enterprise resource planning, ERP systems? They will have, those systems have individual modules like this, and the coordination is through ERP. ERP is nothing but software which coordinates with all of these individual functions. So as a single entity, any company can function. Large organizations, this is how they grow globally. This is how they do pan India work. This is how they, the organizations actually operate, because each of these modules are automated by using ERP. Again, what is ERP? Enterprise Resource Planning Systems, which are nothing but basically for manufacturing or trading or services, a coordinating software among all these functions. Okay, one by one we'll go through these functions. What are the ERP modules? Typically one by one we can go through that. What are the individual modules? First one, financial accounting system. Financial accounting system. So these are all sub functions of any ERP modules. We have to by heart this. We need to remember this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. 11 modules of ERP. We need to remember this even in our sleep, because 1-4 marks question or 6 mark question is guaranteed out of this. This is one of the most important aspects of examination perspective. So any question may come out of any of these modules, but one question is guaranteed. So we need to know the number one, all these 11 modules we need to know for sure. And each individual module, the function of each individual module we need to know. So what happens in financial accounting? I think we know this because we already know how financial accounting works. First module, financial accounting module. What do they do? What are the key features? Why financial accounting module is done? So I have, put the bullet points here in a summarized fashion, summarized manner. So what does it do? Tracking of flow of financial data, that is its primary function. What is financial data? Whatever data related to finance in an organization is financial data. Simple. So one of the first features or key features of this module, tracking of flow of financial data across the organization, used for what? For effective strategic decision making. Where to invest, when to come out of the company, organization, or when to come out of the market, when to merge, when to acquire, when to start new production, when to enter into new markets. These are all decisions. How will they make the decisions? Not only marketing, but finance and accounting data should provide it. And creation of organizational structure, like defining a company, registering a company, company codes, functional areas, credit control, how the credit is coming. These are all parts of financial module. In case of SAP, have you heard a tool called SAP? In case of SAP, financial control module, both financial accounting and controlling module combinedly is called as FICO. F-I-C-O. FICO. Financial controlling module. So these two modules are combined in SAP as one module. SAP is an example. But to understand the general understanding of what and how ERP modules work, first module is financial accounting module, FA module. So it creates organization structure and financial accounting, how it has to happen at a global setting, especially when US requires accounting information, what type of financial reports are required, what type of management communication should be there in terms of financial data, all those things. And general ledger accounting. We know what a general ledger is. Ultimately, all the individual functions of financial accounting, like purchasing, vendor management, asset management, sales and distribution, customer management, human resources, meaning salaries and all. Everything gets inputted to GL. What is GL? General ledger. Financial information, general ledger. Financial integration, general ledger. Financial information systems. So this is one of the companies, NSD ERP system, how it works, and general ledger processing and tax configuration, what type of taxes, maintenance of house of banks, accounts payable, accounts receivable, asset accounting, total number of assets, what is the total value, what is the depreciation, when can we discard some of the previous assets, when we need to add new assets, total accounting of assets. And it has to integrate with sales and distribution also, because ultimately sales and distribution should bring money to the company. The moment money is there, ultimately this money is related to financial and accounting module. So sales and distribution and materials management also. How much money is going out? How many materials are coming in? These things, they coordinate. Financial accounting module coordinates with integrates with sales and distribution and materials management. In SAP, sales and distribution module is called SD module, sales and distribution. And materials management is called MM. So after you complete CA Inter, when you join in your articleship, in some of the organizations where you join, the large global multinational organizations, probably you may work with this one of the ERP tools called SAP, which is a German product, a very huge product, or small products like Tally, T-A-L-L-Y, that is also ERP. All these modules may not be there. Tally is a relatively simpler, smaller ERP package, but Tally is one of the other. Otherwise, Oracle Financials, these are all some examples of ERP. Okay, so one of these things you work on. So what happens in financial accounting? Most of our life in future will be on this. Since we are chartered accountants, most of our life will be using this. So if we have to get trained in any of these software packages, financial and accounting package should be the first priority for us. Okay, so what happens inside? These are various steps. We need to study this. We need to remember this. What are the various aspects of any particular module? In this module, financial and accounting module, what happens? And all this terminology is not new to you. We know all of this. So go through that again from the ICA material, financial module. So I have added some visuals here so that we'll understand how the module and integration works. Okay. The second important module, if you remember, the second important module is controlling module. How to control the finances, when to release the budgets, when to squeeze the budgets, when to do an audit of overall financial accounting systems and controlling part of it. So procedures and all that. So like varieties of cost elements, where the cost happens, cost center accounting, activity based accounting, I think you would have done or you may do in group 2, in CA Inter, called ABC. ABC, mostly about activity based costing. And activity based accounting also is part of it. And then internal audits, production cost, profitability analysis, profit center. So this is after. See, if you look at financial and accounting module, financial accounting module is mostly while the transactions happen, purchasing transactions, purchasing transactions, vendor transactions, asset transactions, sales and distribution transactions. So this is mostly transactional data, financial accounting module data. Whereas controlling is to verify whether all this data is working according to the directions of the management or not. So that's why mostly these are all cost center related accounting. How much cost a particular company and particular location is working? Is it profitable or not? What type of cost it is incurring? And also what activities and activity based accounting also, and all these things again. So from a preparation standpoint or from a real life standpoint, these two, that's why FI, financial information, and financial controlling or financial accounting and control, these two work hand in hand. Like, that's why I said FICO. FICO is the general module. So what is FI? Balance sheets, income statement, cash flow and all that. What is controlling? Total cost center, sales and profit analysis, mostly controlling part of it. So if these two are effective in the organization, financial management is totally, you know, planned and secured. Okay. Pardon me for writing some of these stuff to highlight it so that you will understand how it works. Okay. So don't get distracted with my handwriting, which is not so great, I know that. But from your focus onwards, what are the financial accounting module elements? What are the controlling module elements? What type of controlling module elements are there in controlling module? There will be two. One is cost element, two revenue elements. In case of financial accounting, mostly financial and accounting portion only. Okay, these two are part of controlling modules. That is, same thing is more elaborately explained in ICA material. I think I tried to mention, I tried to explain what is the core of these two modules. Okay, in your preparation, you need to go to a bit deep into the ICA material so that each and every line item also you'll understand what are the, you know, what are cost center accounting issues, what is activity based accounting, different varieties of, you know, process orientation and cross functional events and all that, various departments, how much cost they are incurring to the organization. There must be some accounting. We cannot just allocate the budget and just sit and relax. So these two are the important elements of finance and accounting, finance and control. Are we clear? The first two elements of ERP modules, financial accounting, controlling. All right, moving on. Of course, one of the most important, all these are important, but the one of the most important things is sales and distribution module. Why it is really important? Can anyone tell? Because unless sales happen, company cannot book the revenue. So the bread and butter of any organization actually is sales. Okay, you may question me, you may counter me, sir, if the product is not there, what will they sell? So production is also important, but doesn't mean once the production is done, company is profitable. Only with proper sales, company gets profitable. And only with proper distribution to customers, company gets into profits, and it will lead to the profits. So sales and distribution module, what do we have there? There are some pre-sales activities, meaning sending letters to customers, trying to understand their requirements. Some of those, mostly pre-sales is nothing but marketing. And then once the sales comes, sales order processing, then inventory sourcing, where is inventory, which godown it is, which warehouse it is stored. So all those things we have to, for example, Amazon has a great inventory warehouse in Hyderabad on Bangalore Highway. There is a place called Kothur. They have about two or three godowns there, which are warehouses, where if any order comes, first it goes to the nearby godown, which is in Hyderabad, which is in Bangalore Highway. So there it will identify whether the inventory is there or not. So inventory sourcing, that is called. And then actual delivery using a truck or auto or whatever we call. And then billing happens, and then payment. This is what company actually, the sales cycle is, right? So module related to this, each and every track, number, whether the products are there or not in the inventory, whether it is matching the order number or not, the quantity or not, all those things are, my friends, are automated. There is no manual verification process. There is no manual entry. All these are automated now. So sales and distribution is another module which is a part of ERP package. As an example, in SAP, the module is called SD, sales and distribution. Again, a little more details here. What is the process? What type of features that happen here? So where the organization structure, how to structure a new company codes and storage locations, sales offices, and sometimes sales offices may be totally virtual with digital sales. Sometimes it may be physical. There may be local distributor, maybe a wholesaler, maybe a super stockist. So like that, depending on the organization. Okay. Sometimes retail distributors. Let us say Maruti Cars. Maruti Cars manufacturing directly doesn't send car to the customer, right? Customer has to reach to the local vendor, local agent. Agent in the sense, local, distributor. For example, Varun Motors or Mitra Motors or Harsha Toyota, for example. These are all local distributors. They directly deal with the manufacturer. So manufacturer and local distributor and customers, they will be in coordination so that sales and distribution process happens correctly. Okay. So that's how sales and distribution module works. This is pretty straightforward, visual also, easy to understand, but I strongly suggest and I demand you to go through each one of these in the ICA material so that you will have more explanation and you will have more relevance to why it is mentioned. So I'm explaining all of those, but part of your preparation, you should go through line by line, word by word. Okay. And then another module, what we have is human resource. What is that? Human resource module. Human resource module is it a support function or the main line function, which is the primary function? Do you remember that? Support activities, core activities. Yeah. HR is a support function. It is not the main function. However, it is very important. So what happens in HR? Look at this. Sorry. These many aspects of HR happen. What HR happen or does, what type of steps it follows. It is a visual. So visual actually talks more things. So that I'm explaining that. So if any question comes in the exam also, high level, we should know this flow. So step one is recruiting, then hiring. Recruiting means interview process, elimination process, all those. Even your group discussions, any of the technical rounds which are a written exam or maybe technical interviews, all that is recruitment. Once recruited, then hired, means selected. And then definitely enter into recording to organization and the time and expenses and payments, of course. Why organizations, why employees work there? Payment. And their education process, personal data, family member, dependent information so that insurance can be given, any of the benefits can be given there. And personal development, any further training, further development to the career, any performance appraisals and promotions, change of pay, change of position also may happen, maybe we'll get promoted. Sometimes we may be leaving, so what are the leaves and absenteeism and some of those details. In case we are not working good, even termination is also part of HR. So these are various steps of HR. Whenever at the age and stage where you are, when someone says human resources, HR, what do you do if anyone asks? Immediately what things come to our mind? Oh, they recruit people. No, they do so many other things within the organization also. So these are various steps of HR activities. So this module has so many aspects. So this visual actually explains about all of the activities HR does. So this is mostly, we can understand the HR resource module actually works, and all these details are integrated to the entire system, ERP, centralized database, human resources, centralized database. So go through this, understand various aspects of HR, and then any questions you can get back. This is another module called HR module in ERP packages. And then moving on to something called production planning. Okay, production planning means not actually production only, but for production, when the item should be produced. For example, number of pens to be produced. For example, I am a manufacturing company. I am a gel, maybe German gel manufacturing company, or maybe a Parker company. So how many pens I have to produce this month? How do I know? Let us say I am working on, I'm Dell, the laptop company. Okay, I manufacture laptops. As an organization, as a company, how do I know how many laptops I need to produce? Based on the demand. Where do I get the demand from? From sales. So based on the sales demand, I need to plan for my production. Let us say I am the car manufacturing company. How can I produce? Can I produce 1,000 cars and keep it in godown? Irrespective of the customer demand, then my inventory cost will be high. My maintenance cost will be high. So how to manage the maintenance cost in the within permissible limits? How to produce according to that requires a heavy planning. That's why production planning is one of the most complicated aspects. Yeah, we are all chartered accountants in some time and we'll be working in service industry. But actual production is the toughest job. Why? When to produce, what to produce, how many raw materials, how many co- because let us say I need to manufacture cars, I need some tires, right? Will I procure tires first? Or will I procure engine components? Will I procure plastic? Will I procure glass? Will I procure electronic items for the dashboard like music systems? Should I keep those in godowns? Should I get all those things in time? Those are called just-in-time mechanisms. You would have done some problems in costing. Do you remember those? Just-in-time mechanisms. That means whenever it is required, the required quantity we need to procure, there must be a plan. That plan is called production planning module. Oh, heavily loaded module. And lot of manufacturing organizations use these modules. Okay, so that's why it has to collaborate with what? Master data, sales and operations planning, distribution also, production planning, materials requirement planning, capacity planning. The capacity means how much I need to produce, how much I can. So, and production cost planning also, meaning sometimes we may have to produce and war produce also because of the customer demand. So then machines may not be active. So how can I plan all the shifts? Production cost planning, how much cost I have to. For example, while I estimated manufacturing of a car and the price of a car, the steel price per ton was, let us say, 20,000 rupees. But after 1 month when the actual production started, the overall cost of the production itself, because of maintenance of the machines, because of labor cost, because of raw material not coming up, because there is a delay in raw material and we could not produce, that is all cost. So all those aspects should be in coordination with the module called production planning module, which is nothing but PP module, production planning module. Any manufacturing company deals with this. So some of the ICWA, meaning CMA, friends, when they work in cost area of or costing areas of manufacturing companies, or even for that matter service companies, they do go through the training for production planning. Okay, so like master data, SOP, sales and operation, when the sales and what type of forecasting means demand forecasting, not the supply forecasting, right? Based on the demand forecasting, my production supply has to be there. So this is a very precarious equation. If I produce less, customers will be dissatisfied because they did not get the product. If I produce more, it will be adding to the expenses and cost because of inventory and all the other things. So it is a tight thread, it is a tight rope walk. Similarly, distribution, whether the distribution should be on time or not. For example, think about eatables, think about bread manufacturing, think about milk manufacturing. The overall time to store those may be very less, maybe 2-3 days only at an organization, because those are perishable goods. So the demand is very crucial there. So the distribution also is very important there. So production planning, material forecasting, demand management, long-term planning, and all this. MRP, materials requirement. When do I have to procure what material in sequence? What type of a sequence I should follow? Those things are all part of, you know, MRP, materials requirement planning. Capacity planning, how much capacity that I need to work. Should I work 100% with my capacity or should I work at 80%? If I work at 100%, if I am producing 100 products per hour, is it enough to meet the demand or not? Should I acquire any other plant or should I rent another plant to meet the customer demand? Sometimes it may be otherwise. For example, during Corona, COVID times, lot of production plants were not working at a capacity of 20% also because there was no customer demand. So how can I survive? How can I survive the low customer demand with 20% capacity only? A lot of planning happens. Okay, business is very tough to do, my friends, especially production and manufacturing business. And production cost planning also is part of it. Okay, so issue of raw materials, this is a high level system flow, very easy to understand from a pictorial standpoint. Four steps: raw materials from stores. Stores are nothing but where the inventory is stored. And then conversion to work in progress, meaning process. Conversion to finished goods and stock transfer to godown. Maybe in your costing problems, in your accounting problems, you would have heard all this, but these are real in real life. Okay, I think conversion to work in progress may include more than one step. So finished goods and packing process and all that should be also planned. How long it takes, what are the dependencies, and etc. So I have explained the same in the PPT also in a more pictorial format, a more bullet oriented format. Okay, master data, SOP, sales and operation planning, DRP, distribution resource planning, production planning. So we need to by heart this. If a question comes on production planning, explain. See, they may give a case study. So-and-so ABC company is into manufacturing business and it would like to convert its current process of production planning to ERP. Suggest the steps it has to follow. Naturally, these are the steps. Suggest the steps it has to follow. What are the steps? We have to prepare for these steps. Okay, production planning components. So you have to prepare. You have to write down in your notebook. You have to, by writing down, you have to by heart and understand. When I say by heart, not mugging. Understanding and memorizing is by heart, not mugging. Okay. Then materials management module. Oh, when to have material, because as an organization, we don't have all the raw materials manufactured by us. Let us say you are BMW car manufacturing company. Is BMW manufacturing all the components related to car? No, it is mostly assembly and engine it may have, but all the other it has to assemble. So materials management is really important too. What type of materials should be procured? What type of materials at what point in time they have to plan? So subcomponents are mostly vendor, because materials are nothing but vendors. We need to coordinate. When are we going to consume the existing materials? Purchasing, inventory management, all these are all components of materials management, right? Like logistics, when to supply this? What is logistics? Have you heard about that word? Logistics? Logistics is nothing but transportation from one place to other place. Supply chain management, final delivery, sales and delivery, warehouse management, these are all in coordination with materials management module. So materials management module typically has a diagram like this. So purchase requisition from production department. Production, let us say car manufacturing. Oh, we have 400 cars that need to be manufactured by so-and-so date. There is an order. And for that, what is the purchase request should be given by production department to purchase department. Then quotation has to be added to vendors. Evaluation of quotations. What is the quotation? How much it costs? Let us say we need 500 cars. How many tires we need? Each car has, let us say, 4 tyres, 4 plus 1, 1 spare tyre, total 5 tyres, 5 into 5, 2500 tyres. Are we going to give directly to one company like Apollo tyres or Seat tyres like a contract? No, we should have a selection of vendors, that is called quotation. Vendors should send a quotation. Then materials management, meaning stores, evaluates it and then placing an order. Receipt of the material by stores, issue of material to production, because ultimately stores is nothing but godown. Inventory, they have to send it to production, and recording the purchase by accounts and release of payments to vendors. So how the payment terms? Oh, that depends on the vendor to vendor. So this is how the steps are. And while receiving the material, there is something called GRN, maybe you would have used in accounting. There is something called MRN, material receipt note, or GRN, goods receipt note. So note down all those in the accounting process and then close the final payment to vendor. Who does all this? In coordination with finance, materials management, because materials management doesn't own finance. It has to coordinate with finance department. Finally, that has to be recorded in the accounts department. Oh, this is integration, my friends. Okay, I hope you are getting the point. You are understanding how beautifully organizations work together. Within the, not multiple organizations together, within the organizations, all the departments work together. They are in synchronization, they are in harmony, okay? Then only organizations are successful, and ERP systems make that happen. That is a business objective, okay? Then moving on to quality management. Maybe this is something some of us may end up with, because in a lot of organizations, audit is a part of quality management. What is quality management? Quality planning should be there, quality control should be there, quality assurance should be there, and quality improvement. It is a continuous process. So what is quality planning? How much quality we should have for each of the products or each of the services? Is it 99% approved based on the requirements? Is it 98% okay? So always have some quality planning first. Plan quality. And then there are two things. Quality management in terms of assurance. Quality assurance. And then quality control. What is quality assurance? Process, whether it is working correctly or not. That is assurance. Quality control is whether the product is related to the output or not, according to the standard or not. So quality control, QC is about product. Write it down in your notebook. Quality control equal to product. Quality assurance is about data. Process data, whether the process is currently working or not. For example, the machine has to run successfully and produce 100 AC machines per hour. Let us say that is the original process. But is it producing according to the process or not? Verification. Metrics. Why it is not working? Why, in what part of the production it is stopping? Which is actually hindering the process? So measure the quality assurance, which is process. I hope you are writing it down. Quality control is about product. 100 products should come out. And out of 100 products, how many products are faultless? Or how many products are acceptable? Most of us think that Chinese products are of low quality, right? Have you ever heard that feeling? When you are talking about phones, Chinese phones. Oh, Chinese phones, Chinese products, hey, those are low quality. But how? If China is producing only low quality products, how can it is delivering to almost 90% of world products? Do you think US and UK and European companies or countries and their own product, their own companies, do they accept faulty products from China? No. It has to be 99.999% accurate. Then how can we say Chinese products are of low quality? Because for Indian market, they are selling the low quality. That we have to understand. Anyway, out of context, but how do they verify? I mean, a lot of my friends actually do business, and for their business requirements, they go to China to procure some of the products and all that. At least earlier, not now, because of the political tensions and all that, they have reduced the Chinese trips. But earlier, then, when they go to Zhangdao province, for example, or Jiangsu province, there are varieties of, you know, products, variety. It's a huge world, different world altogether. You know what they say? Once they go there, same company, same Chinese organization, we may not even know the name. The same Chinese company may produce two different varieties of products. Let us say I need to produce a pen, or let us say a computer, for A, which is European and Western, for B, mostly Asian, meaning India and other countries, Mexico, even South American also. For A, it will be 99.9% quality. For B, it will be 80% quality. So cheap quality, they dump here. Export quality, they export to US and UK and all that. So that's how they manage quality control. And of course, quality assurance also, they'll time and again manage whether the process is working correctly or not. Same with, for example, Japanese. If you take Japanese products, are universally similar quality. Typically, they aim for 99.9% everywhere, whether Honda is in India or Toyota is in India or US or UK. Honda is Honda, Toyota is Toyota, or, you know, Nissan is Nissan. Why? Because universally they follow the same quality standards, quality control standards, quality assurance standards. But in case of other countries, it may vary. I mean, just as an example, I'm telling. So what is quality? That is quality. Two varieties. One, process control. Process control to product control. Process control is called quality assurance. Are you writing it down? Simple bullet point. Process control is equal to quality assurance. Product control is equal to quality control. So product quality, process quality. I hope you understand it by now. Okay? So to manage this, they will have integrated change control, all the departments work together. And definitely the management and project execution also, meaning project managers work on this. So quality planning, quality control. So quality control again is about manufactured goods, like I told, products. Then what is quality assurance? It is about identifying the processes and their interactions in sequence. Process quality, product quality. What is process quality? Quality assurance. What is product quality? Quality control. So these two are very, very important topics. It can be a short answer question also. And naturally, quality improvement is a universally accepted phenomena. It is a never-ending process. Okay? That is how quality management modules work. So they set master data targets, quality management plan is prepared, and then actions to measure quality, how to measure the quality in terms of quality assurance and quality control, meaning processes and products. And finally, reports and all that will be there, and improvement. Quality has to be improved at multiple points. So this is how quality is mentioned. So why did I explain a little more in detail about it? Because most of us may not know this. Okay, we can talk about accounting, we can talk about controlling, because we know some of those aspects in costing. We know some of those aspects from financial management. But quality management is totally different animal. We never worked in any processing plant or manufacturing plant or service company like telecom or insurance or business. By the way, these concepts of quality assurance and quality control apply to service industry also, especially the BPO industry, business process outsourcing. I hope you heard the word, and a lot of us actually look at that industry as very low business. Yeah, it is. Why? Because it is mostly about quality control. Once the product is sold, any customer complaints, that is very low end work. So quality management module actually manages some of those. All right, but the basic purpose of quality management module is before the product goes out to the customer, how the quality has to be improved. It is not after. Once the customer has experienced the product and when and then they complain, already goodwill of the organization is lost, is it not? Hence, every organization has, before the product or a service rolled out to the customer or sold out to the customer, it has to follow these two areas of quality management. Important is quality control and as well as quality assurance. Okay, I hope you got the overall picture of quality management. All right, go through this again and you will understand much better. Moving on, the screen is so rough and also untidy. That's okay, that's the purpose of it, right? Making more black white sheets to either red or black, that is called preparation, that is called understanding. Just by looking at it, reading it doesn't mean anything. So 8, plant maintenance module. Okay, we are manufacturing things. There is a machine that manufactures let us say 100 computers per hour, and we have been producing it based on the sales, but suddenly machine got a breakdown. What happened to our production? So machines need to be maintained. Plants have to be maintained. What is maintenance? I think two wheelers, we know. Why do we service them? Why do we give to service, oil change, any other cleaning processes? Because machines need to be maintained. Plant has to be maintained. So large organizations need a planning for that also, because it is not manual. It has to be automated. Those have to be scheduled. So maintaining of the equipment and enabling efficient planning and control or production, so that the schedules will be met. All the employees are there, all the workers are there, but machine is down. Can we say to employees that, hey Tuch, sorry, machine is down, we will not pay to you? Can we say to the customer that please wait for us, the parts have to come from Germany, until we replace the parts we cannot give the, then customer will be dissatisfied, or they will go to some other company, some other competitor. So plant maintenance is also important. So to achieve minimum breakdown, that is one of the major objectives, to keep the machines and other facilities in condition so that optimum profit making capacity should be there. And to ensure the availability of the machines, buildings and services required by the other sections also, we need to maintain it. So what data may be there, equipment master, what equipment is there, equipment plant, when we bought it, when the service scheduled service is, all this is automated. Automatic messages go to mechanics, fitters or electricians, and they do complete the maintenance. There is no manual intervention. They get the reports, they get the indications, they get the heads up messages. Okay, you are within this plant, as an electrician, you have to go and verify all the electric components on so and so date. Automatic maintenance process, that is, or this equipment has to be replaced by after 2 years or 3 years, or every 15 days this has to be overhauled, or maybe so huge maintenance processes, very important for organizations to deliver the products. So different reports will be there. If you look at the centralized plan, equipment and plant history should be there, and in that information on type of machines and control, equipment master, total list of equipments, plant master, how many plants are there, and then information on items and each of the items, so nuts, including nuts and bolts and smallest possible things also. We cannot ignore anything, right? For example, we are a car manufacturing company, the assembly line, that means where the assembly happens, it requires certain hydraulic pressure or pneumatic pressure, for example. Hydraulic is generally the use. So that has to be active every day. So there must be some verification every 1 week or 2 days or something like that. Terms and parts. Maintenance data also should be maintained, whether it is maintained correctly on date or not. And yearly schedule, plant maintenance schedule should be released. What is the output of it? These are all the inputs. If you look at, the arrows are going into the database. What does this database give? reminder reports, scheduled reports, monthly reports, history reports. Where are we? So that organizations don't miss the production. Because if we miss the production, sales cannot promise anything to customers. If sales are not selling anything to customers, plant is under losses, company is under losses. So these are all integrated issues. Okay? All right. Project systems module, portfolio management. This is mostly project management. Every organization requires project managers, portfolio managers, program managers. So this module actually helps them. What does it contain? Basically, mostly reporting processes. How a project has been initiated, and then create various different templates. Templates are nothing but formats. What type of report should be there? What type of allocation should be there? Resource allocation and all, that's all project management activity. For a particular shift, how many people should be important? If I have 50 people, what would be the productivity? If we have 20 people and 3 shifts, how the productivity would be? All those things are part of templates. So creating a project, project planning, budgeting and release, implementation, completion. This is how projects are done. And each project can be like this only in most of the cases. Okay, their methodologies may be different. How the should there be a day-to-day meeting? Should there be monthly meeting? Should there be weekly meeting? Should there be how the review should be? All those things may vary, but ultimately this is how the process of project systems. When they say project systems, nothing but project management. Okay, so that's the reason why project managers, they use SAP modules, and their module is generally called PSM, project systems module. Of course, Microsoft also has its own modules. Microsoft Project is a software. A lot of people use it. In civil construction and some of the mechanical construction units, there are tools like Primavera. I don't know, these are all new to you, and maybe Overboard and Bouncers also to you. But these are all various project management tools in the market. How people or companies, organizations use that. So this is also one of the modules in SAP or ERP. And supply chain management, I think most of you would have heard about it. Supply chain, right from the raw material till the product, how this is a product is distributed to sales and customers. Basically, raw material, and then it has to be from to supplier, and then to manufacturing, from their distribution to customer, and finally to consumer. So customer and consumer are different. I hope you know that. Customer is the one who pays for it. Consumer is the one who uses it. Sometimes customers and consumers are different. Many a time customers and consumers may be same. So for organizations, customer and consumer, they have to distinguish. So supply chain management has various different modules. It is a network of business entities collectively responsible for what? For procurement, manufacturing, distribution activities with one or more families of related products. So this module provides extensive functionality for logistics. Logistics means transportation of products or raw materials, manufacturing, planning, analytics like inventory, supply chain planning, supplier scheduling, general stuff. You don't have to buy hard this, but we should understand the big picture. Supply chain management means not only transportation, it has various steps in it. If you understand that, more than enough as of now. Okay, the process in supply chain, this is another module. That's why there is a supply chain module separately, management system module, which is huge. And lot of these retail e-commerce companies like Amazon, Flipkart, they are all supply chain experts. If you know, the moment customer orders, from then onwards, how to fulfill that order, supply chain management works. Where there is inventory, how the go down, where it is coming from, if that is not there, where is the manufacturer, how can we get it from the manufacturer, how soon we can deliver, in case during the delivery if damage happens, how to track it, is customer happy with the delivery, is it on time, all those things are part of supply chain management. And these electronic e-commerce companies have made, especially in the retail business, like Big Basket, these are all world's largest supply chain companies, including Swiggy. because they do deliver, as simple as that, and they make customers happy through delivery. They may not manufacture, in fact they don't, but the module what they focus mostly is supply chain management module. Large organizations like Tata Cars or maybe Maruti Suzuki Cars, they have a supply chain by themselves. Who is their customer? The distributors are their customers or retailers, and finally it may reach to a consumer through the distributor. All that is part of supply chain management, and this tracking happens, this coordination happens, this centralized database actually helps to customer satisfaction is finally by using supply chain management modules. And ultimately how to maintain the customer, because without the customer relationship any company will not survive. So customer should be happy, customer should be satisfied. Happy is a different thing, satisfaction. So that is called customer relationship management module. It's called CRM module, which is a separate module. Most of the online companies actually work on this, and most of the e-commerce companies, they work on it. How customer should be happy, what makes a customer happy, all the data what we enter in the internet. I think there is a huge issue with WhatsApp. I think day before yesterday or so, or some other time within this week, or whenever you are trying to follow the session, there is an issue with WhatsApp. WhatsApp has sent a message that all to all users that your data will be shared with Facebook and all business details and all that. Why? What they say? To serve you better as a customer. That's what they say. Why? Because improving the customer relationship is a part of CRM module. CRM is nothing but customer relationship management module, CRM. It's called CRM. There are various companies that work on CRM separately also. There are various companies work on supply chain management also, but these are all part of one huge centralized database for organizations. Okay, so what does CRM do? CRM actually improves the customer relationship. It increases the customer revenues. Upselling and cross-selling happens. Upselling means we ask for a product, but that product is not there within this price range, and they will sell something above the price range. That is upselling. What is cross-selling? We ask for one product like pen. They may sell the ink also, I mean the refills also. We ask for let us say a trouser, they will sell the shirt also, meaning cross-selling. These are all, how do they know? That is called customer relationship management. Somehow they try to convince us, not manually, now it is all digital, by throwing more and more features, more and more offers. Those are all part of customer relationship management module. They work closely with marketing. And what is better in internal communication? Definitely it will give better internal communication, and it will optimize marketing. That's what I was saying, right? CRM directly works with marketing, so that better marketing products will be released. So this is explained in theory here. So improved relations, increased customer revenues, upselling and cross-selling. I explained you the concept of upselling and cross-selling. Upselling means trying to put and feature a product which is of higher price. We have searched for, let us say, a product of 500 rupees, and they may sell us ultimately 700 rupees product. That is upselling. Cross-selling, we asked for some product, we asked for a laptop, and they will sell antivirus also, or mouse, and some of the other accessories also. That is cross-selling. Okay, and all this happens through their centralized database. Okay, so supply chain management, after that CRM, it will optimize the customer relationship management also. So these are 11 modules of ERP. I hope we have explained, and I gave a diagrammatic representation also how the CRM works in terms of sales planning, in terms of customer portal, and there are companies for CRM also separately I mentioned. So CRM, an important point about CRM, CRM does not directly interact with customers to complete a transaction. It is only back end. It uses tables from ERP, and it has all the details, contact details, customer details, sales details as tables. That's how CRM works. I think I have to remind you again, we are not programmers. So we just need to know how and what CRM is. That's enough. I hope you understand that now. So these are the 11 modules of ERP. FICO, Financial Accounting and Control, Sales and Distribution and HR, Production Planning, Materials Management, Quality Management, Plant Maintenance, Project Systems, which is Project Management and Portfolio Management. What is Portfolio? Varieties of products. And Supply Chain Management and Customer Relationship Modules. Okay? It's a heavily loaded, like any session, it is a heavily loaded session with various components of any ERP system, any modules, varieties of modules of ERP. I hope you have gone through reasonable details about ERP modules. Then now we will understand how the integration with other modules happen. This is just an extension of the discussion. So what type of integration with other modules happen? For integration of modules with financial and accounting system, definitely master data has to be shared. Common transaction data should be shared. Voucher types separately should be used. And transaction may flow across departments, like closing stock may be taken to trading account as well as balance sheet. Two places it may be entered. So we need to understand where the transactions may be giving the data. How to integrate or what are the integration points? Materials management and FICO. This can be a good question. You are a part of a financial controlling module, and what are all the integration points with other modules of your organization? Materials management integration, definitely material valuation should be there, vendor payments and all those things will go to GL, general ledger. So this is a general information. So if a question like this comes, imagine or creatively think. Materials management definitely deals with the accounting. So list of material that were valued, what are the vendors, how did they pay, material costing and all that. Those things can be understood as a part of coordination with financial controlling. HR, does it have a coordination with financial controlling? Of course, payroll, all the salaries. Who controls those? Who keeps the records? Both HR as well as financial controlling. And then material management with production planning also. Why? Like I think I mentioned, or we mentioned in the, while we are going through production planning. Every production planning module will have what type of material should be procured, when should be procured, whether it is based in stocks, meaning within the inventory, what are the expected receipts, issues, planned orders, when are they going to arrive. Accordingly, production planning should happen. So always there is a interrelation, sorry. And material management integration with sales and distribution, does it not? Oh yeah, delivery, availability check, stock transfers from one place to other place, whether sales order, is it scheduled for delivery or not. So definitely material management actually manages the stock, and sales and distribution should be in coordination with it. Materials management with quality management, oh yeah. Wherever the products are, wherever the raw materials are, quality management verifies those. So should we have a coordination? Should we have an integration with materials management and quality management, QM? Oh yeah, yes. Mostly materials management with plant maintenance. What materials should be produced, procured, when to, based on the maintenance of the plant. When the required raw material for plant maintenance is there. There should be the purchase orders for that. So plant maintenance also works with materials management. So like that, coordination happens. So as an example, a case of an ice cream manufacturing company to see various, this is about your creativity again. What are the various modules that are in an ice cream manufacturing company? Ultimately it is a manufacturing company. So same list of modules apply there. Materials maintenance, production module, same thing. Supply chain management, financial and accounting, human resources, sales and distribution, how it works. What type of, each steps within the modules, how do they actually interact? We should know. So whatever we have discussed today should be applied to this. There is no specificity whether it is ice cream manufacturing or whether it is air conditioning manufacturing, whether it is a laptop manufacturing. The modules are same. Wherever the modules are, integrate those modules and try to write down the details. Hence, your preparation for the individual modules is really important. What happens in individual modules? That's the today's session. So refer to this again, go through each and every module, remember step by step and try to note it down, and accordingly we can, you know, work on, or we can remember the aspects of it. In the our CHAMS material, I have mentioned inventory accounting also. Now it is not there in the new material, so it is not required. So how we can integrate, I think we mentioned this. Okay. So the integration also we have discussed about, and there is a small example. So whatever we have learned today can be applied here also. Any example for that matter. So if we understand, if we have a general common understanding of various modules, how these modules are important in any manufacturing company or any service company, we have to creatively think about it. As simple as that. Okay. With that, probably I'll put a stop here for this session so that we can start about enterprise information systems, but MIS, there is something called management information. What management requires, what type of reports they require, and all of that. So ERP is done. Explanation about ERP and ERP systems, audit of ERP systems, we have gone extensively through these sessions. So please go through this material as a part of your preparation. Write down the notes, or notes in the sense, if you want to write long notes, it's up to you, but majorly the bullet points, the key salient points. And then refer to the material of ICAI as well as CHAMS. A lot of overlap is there, but still it gives more visual representation in CHAMS, and some examples from internet also. And then accordingly you should prepare. So before close this session, if any questions are there, please don't hesitate to post it in our common WhatsApp group. I will respond back. Don't miss that opportunity to question things. Okay, use your questions as a weapon to learn things. With that, till we meet next time, thank you very much. Bye.